Some glad day when all our troubles. prayer and ask God's guidance, because I know family are hurting, but I also know who can bring peace and comfort and content during this time. And know that He is still on the throne. He sees our needs, He hears our cries. Heavenly Father, we come to You today, Lord, on behalf of our family. Lord Jesus, You know their hearts are hurting, the situation in their life. But Lord Jesus, we know, God, that You've got everything in control and are Your hands. And Lord, I just pray today, Father, that Your Holy Spirit would lead us in this service. And Lord Jesus, that Your will be accomplished, Lord, in Your word. And Father, we just pray, Father, for comfort, peace that only You can give. We know the world can't give this peace, Father, that comes from You. We know nobody can, Lord, but You, Lord Jesus, can. And Lord, You know the hearts, and You know the cries, and You know the hurts. But Lord, You also see the smiles and see the good times, Lord, they had with this dear lady, Miss Shirley. But Lord Jesus, we know we put this service into Your hands. And Lord, we ask You, Lord, for the words that, Lord, You would have me to share this morning. And God, more than anything else, Lord, to lift them up, Father, and to give them strength for the days ahead. In Your precious name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Knowing life, you can have everything in this world.
You can be the wealthiest individual, you can have all the things that this world can offer you. And say, well, I've made it. I finally got there. I've accomplished what I wanted to do. I'm where I want to be in life. But you know what? If you don't have Jesus Christ and don't have friends, you don't have anything. It's like where I come from, Tazewell County, and say, you ain't got nothing. You don't have anything without, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior, and you don't have friends. Because in this world, you can't buy them for a season, but it's just for a season. But true friends mean a lot. And she had friends. Miss Shirley had friends. And family, you got friends. The ones that are here today, they're able to be here supporting you as a family. But not only that, the ones came through last night. And also, the phone calls, the text messages. Do you need anything? Anything we can do? Check it on you. The flowers, you name it. All that, the food says to you that you're well loved. It speaks highly. I'm assured that you were well loved, and she was loved. And you see, that means a lot in this day of time. And to know you've got friends that have been there with you even in these times, and even in this today, this past week, and the weeks I find that you've had friends to say, you need anything, or we're praying for you. Because that means more than anything else in this world, that you got people praying for you. Because without prayers, I wouldn't be here and you wouldn't be here. Jesus Christ, He's the answer. And this service today, God's got it. Let me tell you something, the Lord's got it. He knows what we need. He sees our heart and the cries of our heart. And He hears the needs of our situation, no matter who we are. The same what we look like and what we've been through, Jesus says, I care about you. I love you. And this is not only a time of day that we come together, as they say in the morning. But I want you to know, it is also a service today for her, a celebration. And I'll share that with you in a little while. Why? Because I'm telling you, God has got it. He's got it in His hands. And He knows what He's doing. Listen to the words of this next song. Matthew chapter 11. Christ tells us, Jesus himself tells us, that when we're going through times of life and situations of life, even in times where we are today, that Jesus said, I'll always be with you. And he's the only one that can really bring the true peace and the comfort, because he is God and he knows our hearts. But in Matthew 11, he says in verse 28, and families at this time, I know Scott, Belinda, mom's not here, she's gone. Mom then took her flight. But yet to know that you were left here in family because she loved you. And she wanted you to know that you would be taken care of. You know that growing up. But she loved her family. Even the grandchildren, the great-grandchildren, especially one, a little hardy, I mean, what can I say? He keeps me on my toes on Sunday morning, so, which is good. But you know, she loved you. You know, some of the greatest things I remember, and know this dear lady, when she was able to go in there, it was that smile. And she got a smile. It meant a lot. And no matter I've seen her in certain places, with the wind or whatever, and the sisters there, you know, and the whole family, you know, or family affair, she always had that smile. That smile. And so when Jesus said in this life, when he said, come unto me, all you that labor or heavy laden, and he says, I will give you rest. Glenn McCullough can't give you rest. Nobody can give you that rest except Jesus Christ in these days that we're in. He's the only one. Then he says, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am meek, gentle, and lowly in heart, and you will find rest unto your souls. For Jesus said, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. And what he's saying today, that yes, Miss Shirley is gone, but yet to realize that there is peace that you can have and rest in your heart spiritually and emotionally is through Jesus Christ. No matter what we face, no matter what we go through, that he's always there. And that he always will be there. And to know that, Lord, without you, where would I be? And yet, family, I realize that going through life and the years that she worked, was able to work, retiring from Williams Oil Company there and failed as office manager and all that she did. And yet, I realize that the home never will be the same. It never is. It's different. Because I know that you have good memories and you've had some tough memories with sickness and all that's going on. I know it seemed like not that long ago, just a short while, that we were here. And you see, we can. And you say that, and I know, Belinda, that it's not going to be right because you were able to be around and be there for both of them and do. And it's that's something you're going to miss because you were there to help them. Though you saw in their pain that it went through that your heart was hurting, but you were there. And so you don't have to have a mom to take care of, but you got a family to think about and to carry on. When Scott gets out of line, when she can't put him in, sister, fall in line is all I can say. That's all I can say. But you know, God is good. In life, we take things for granted. And I'm just going to tell you like it is. Now, someone said to Glenn, that's the only way to know. That's the only way to give it from the Lord. That in these last times on this earth, he and her went through a lot. Him battling cancer, her being battling what she was having. Let me tell you something. All that she was going through is tough too. And to realize what it can do for you in your life. And realize that dementia is not something to take easy. It's a cancer too. And it works at you. But you know, I know a God that knows our hearts and our lives. You know, in life, Jesus Christ said, I came that I could give you life, that I could die for your sins and resurrection, that you'd have life eternally. And I was just sitting back there and just thanking the Lord that, you know, Lord, I sure want to be able to stroll over heaven. And here comes a song, Stroll Over Heaven with You. And I begin to think about her. And I begin to think about, you know, that about last week I got a text, you know, we don't talk on phones anymore, we just text one another, so, which is fine. You know, I like it, you know, I got used to it. But I still like to hear your voice. And but a letter text me says, Glenn, it's not good. Mama's not gonna be here much longer. And I text back, where I was at. I said, all possible, I will be there tonight some way. And yet, let me tell you something. Don't take things for granted in this life. Life is short, no matter how young you are, how old you are. But you know, we take life for granted and that, well, Lord, I'm just going to wait and to the last, I'm going to enjoy my life out here, and then maybe, you know, I might turn around, but you may not get a chance to give your life to Jesus Christ. But I'm going to tell you something. I've witnessed it a few times, what God can do. And yet, let me tell you something. You must always keep your heart in mind and realize, Lord, there is a heaven, but there is a hell. Hell's a real place. It's nothing to make fun of. It's scripture. But he did not create it for us. It was supposed to be for, that don't mean Satan and his fallen angels. The angels that fell with Satan. But yet, man is occupying it. Souls are occupying it. But I want to tell you something like this, too. Some may say, well, with her dementia, and when I got that text, and then Felina, she says, man, I just want to know she's all right. I want to know that she's made it right with God. Now, that's love from a family. And so when I came over, we went into the bedroom, and yes, you someone say, well, she don't know what you were saying. But I'm going to tell you what, there was someone else in that room. And Melinda felt that too. There was something powerful in that room, and that was the Holy Spirit. That Holy Spirit's real. But I'm telling you, you don't take chances with life. You understand me? Get it right. But let me tell you something. Linda told me that I was praying God. I know there's nothing impossible that you can't do. And I know that we think of the words that we say to give our life to you. But Lord Jesus, I know that you are God. And we begin to pray. And I begin to pray since we're asking, Lord Jesus, come into our heart. If she's not right, get it right. And something happened. The Holy Spirit began to move. Very real, very strong. And then Miss Shirley began to squeeze my hand.
Hallelujah.
Something happened. You know what happened? Jesus happened. There was no doubt in my mind. And I thank Melinda, you were a little caught off because the Holy Spirit's real. It ain't a name on the door, a Pentecostal church, but it's real. It's real. That's why I know I can see her again. And her kin is strolling over heaven. Because of what Jesus Christ did and bore witness that he's real. And there's no doubt in my mind, I know where Shirley is. And yet, I know and I thank God that she is not in this world. You say, well, that's taken away from the family. No, not the condition she was in. And I notice God, the Leonard family knew that, Lord, we hate to see her like this, the way we're seeing her. But let me give you the assurance of what God has for us in Revelation 21. And close with this, I want you to understand, the love of God is powerful. He loves you, he loves you, he loves you. It don't matter who you are. He loved Miss Melinda. It don't matter what name you go by. No matter what's on the end of your name, if you're a color or whatever, or if you're McDaniel's, it doesn't matter. It's what's in your heart. It's who you know. Jesus Christ, and to know that only the children of God will have this blessing, and what I'm about to read to you through Jesus Christ. You have to know the Lord in your heart and accept him. And to know the life that she lived, the family getting together, the times that they were together, things and places, as I said, there's been some tough memories, but remember the good memories. I always like to say, I remember that smile. And that's what I want you to know, that Jesus Christ loves us. And he wants us to remember his smile, that he cares so much about us. But there's coming a day, that in verse chapter 21 of Revelation, that where God said, through his servant John, now I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away. Also there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be be their God. And God shall wipe away all the tears, every tear from their eyes. And there shall be no more death, no sorrow, no crying. Thank God there shall be no more pain. For the former things are passed away that are gone. And you know, that's real. And that's what I'm looking for, to see the Lord, see Jesus Christ. That's the most important. And to know that when you go through the suffering of this life, that one day there'll be no more pain. She is in no more pain. She is in no more suffering. She has it together. She has that new life in Jesus Christ. And the most precious thing of all is that you know Him, and you know Him in here. But life is getting shorter. And I'd rather have my Jesus than all the world. And all the things that you can give me in this world, I'll take Jesus anytime. Because families, I'm telling you, what God said in His Word, I think it's soon, very soon, if you know the Lord in your heart, we're going to see the King. And we're going to see Jesus first, but we're going to see our loved ones that have gone on before us, that you will. And soon and very soon, the King is coming. And I'll tell you something else. No government, no politician, no man will give you the peace that Miss Shirley has right now. Nobody will save America. Only God's grace, and God says, I've had it. America's changing. You know what, Amy? She's gone. She's been made over. I used to think, Lord, I'm staying here as long as I can, but now when a loved one goes on, and one goes on, I say, Lord, how much longer? And the Holy Spirit is saying, time is getting shorter. America is gone. God says in His Word, get thee right. Get your heart right with me. Get it together. Don't take a chance. Family, we're going to see it. We know what we got to do. That's the most important. Lord, I love this family. I love this church and the Father. I thank you for each one that came to be here today, Lord, to support our family. And Lord Jesus, we thank you, Father, that the most beautiful part of all life, that Lord Jesus, you reached out to Miss Shirley, and she reached out to you. And Lord Jesus, you took her hand the other day. You took her home. And Lord Jesus, I pray today for the family. And yes, there will be some days ahead. There will be tears of crying, and there's nothing wrong with tears. And Lord, there will be tears of times to know, Lord, that Father, how much longer? But then there will be smiles. Might even be laughter of something that Mom did or this little one did that was funny. But Lord Jesus, most of all, to know that you are with them and that you will always be there. And Lord, we pray for your guidance and your direction. Pray for this family. Keep your arms wrapped tight around them. And lift them up, Lord, in the days that are ahead. And they find that true, deep peace in their heart to know, Jesus, that you are the way, the truth, and the life, and my peace, and my comfort. And Lord, know that I can see Mom again. Grandma, sister, great-grandma. And one day, we can see her again. And Lord Jesus, we love you, Lord. We love this family with all our heart. And thank you for your presence. And thank you, Lord, for Linda reaching out and the family reaching out and being concerned. But Lord, all is peace. Because, Lord, there's no doubt where she left the other day to go. She's with you. And Father, we give you glory and praise for it all. In your precious name, Jesus. Amen.
Slowly watched you love.
I was